श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्यः कवितार्किककेसरी वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि रामानुजदयापात्रं ज्ञानवैराग्यभूषणम् श्रीमद्वेङ्कटनाथार्यं वन्दे वेदान्तदेशिकम्
சீரொன்று தூக்கத் திருவேங்கடமடையான் பாரொன்று சொன்ன பழிமொழியும் ஓரொன்றுதானே அமையாதோ தாரணியில் வாழ்வார்க்கு வானேர கோமலமும் வாழ்வு தத்துவ பதவி இன்ட்ரோடக்ஷன் ஆஃப் தே வி வில் கோ டு தி நெக்ஸ்ட் பாராகிராஃப் ஸோ பிரசாதாத்து தேசிகேந்திரானா பராவர விபாக வித்து பிரபன்ன பரமாத்மானம் பிராப்னோதி பரமம் பதம் திஸ் இஸ் தி வே தட் மெத்தடாலஜி விச் வி கோ பை டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் தி வேர்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஐ வுட் ஈவன் பிசீச் சம்வன் ஹூ இஸ் ஆல்ரெடி ஃபேமிலியர் வித் திஸ் டு கிவ் அஸ் தி மீனிங் ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் அவே இன் ஷார்ட் அண்ட் தெர் ஆர் word by word meanings in the text as you see the monitor and therefore one can easily understand and there are some footnotes also so those footnotes also will be explained at the end of each page and this is how we go and we are conducting these sessions only on Saturdays and Sundays you are welcome at this hour and in case there is some inconvenience for you not to attend this then you can send a private message by WhatsApp and not in a group so you can inform us earlier you can inform us later you are welcome at any time you can go off at any time there is no restriction so what I want to say is please try to attend And if, as Keshavdas Swami put it, you can either put your questions in the chat and conveniently ask at the end of the session. The session can be extended for your questions also, but all of us must have patience. So you have this is how the prose order is given. I will tell you before we go to the word by word meaning. So Deshikendranam Prasadat. Now Vedanta Deshika believes in the blessings of the former preceptors and therefore Deshika Indrana, the leaders of the guides. So, namely, there are three important guides because this Sampradaya tradition has been called Munitraya Sampradaya. Munitraya Sampradaya. Muni. So, Muni means sage. One who has controlled especially anger and who has been meditating on God 24/7, therefore he is called Muni. Therefore, first preceptor in our tradition is Natha Muni and then you have Yamunacharya Muni, Yamuna Muni and then lastly Ramanuja Muni. So, following these three, Deshika Indra, he says he has received blessing. Prasada. Just to be very casual, the word prasada is what you call in ordinary terms some food item, generally food item. And prasada is tulasi, basil leaves, asimam sanctum from the temples of Vishnu, and then kumkumam in the temples of Tayar, the goddess of Mahalakshmi, goddess Mahalakshmi, and so on. And you have the Vibhuti from the Shiva temple. Then so many other, say for example, turmeric, manjal podi. Today, manjal kapu we call it. So that is given from the goddess sanctorum. These are all called prasada. And again, at home, when we offer the food to God and then take it, it is called prasada. Otherwise, it is called sadaha. Tamil sadam. Arisi. It's not rice, it's cooked rice. The word for cooked rice is odana. Odana. That is why we call the curd rice dadhyodana. Dadhi, dadhi odana. And otherwise called it is annam, as you all know. Annam. So these are called prasadaha, as we say, refer to food item. Anything offered to God is prasada. Earlier. That is without our consuming earlier. So prasadat deshikendranam para avara vibhagavi. So a person, that person is called prapannaha in the second line. Prapannaha, a surrendery, one who has surrendered to God, prapannaha. He knows what is highest, what is the lowest. Para avara vibhagavi. Para, param is highest. There is nothing higher than the highest. Avara is lower. So, vibhaga is differentiation. Vitu means knower. So knower of the highest and the lowest. That is, what is the difference between Paramatma and Jivatma and Paramatma and Chetanam and Achetanam. So I think we have introduced these two words yesterday. Insentient and sentient. So these are all lowest than the highest, namely Paramapurusha. So Paramatmanam, Paramam Padam, Prapnoti. Both are almost same. So having reached the Vaikuntha, Paramam Padam, the highest abode, otherwise called in Tamil Tirunadu, otherwise called Kalanka Pirunagar in Tamil. So Prapnoti reaches Paramatmanam, the Lord, the highest Lord, the Supreme Soul. So this is general meaning now. So this is the prose order. So prapannaha, deshikendranam prasadat paravara vibhagavit paramampadam paramatmanam prapnoti. This is the prose order. This is called in Sanskrit anvayaha. A-N-V-A-Y-A. Now the explanation is given in deep. So you have tadacharya prasadattale. Sadacharya prasadattale. Yesterday we were talking about the choice of the preceptor. And therefore, we must have a good teacher, Sadacharya. Satu acharya, satu is good. So prasadattale means by blessing. So instead of deshikendrana, so he translates into another Sanskrit word. So sadacharya prasadattale. Then again, para avara tattva jnanam. So this is in what we call Mani Pravalam language. So Mani is Sanskrit, Pravalam is Tamil. Or you can take exchange also this way. So Paravara Vibhagavitu is now retranslated into Sanskrit. Para Avara Tattva Jnana. So Para Avara, Para the highest, Avara the lowest. Tattva is, you can say all the three principles, namely Chetanam, Achetanam and Paramatma. At any time you can ask me, interact me with the question if you don't understand the particular word. So Tattvam in English we call it principle, Tamil Kolhai, Jnanam is Arivu, wisdom in English, and that is the Paragnyan, the wisdom of the Supreme, the eternal wisdom. So Pirandavan, one who is born. So anybody who is born is Pirandavan. That is Jivatma. Sarveshwaran Tiruvadigalaye. So we are talking about the word Paramatmanam in Sanskrit into Sarveshwaran in Tamil. So Sarva Isharaha. So you will get the Nama is name in the Vishnu Sahasranama. Sarveshwaraha. Isharaha. Isharaha meaning one who has got Aishwaryam. Aishwaryam meaning leadership. Normally we think in Tamil Aishwaryam meaning wealth. But whereas we are talking about this Aishwaryam means leadership. So Sarveshwaraha is omnipotent. So there is no one more powerful than him. So Thiruvadigalaye. திருவடிகளையே நவ வை வி சே திருவடிகளையே வி ஆர் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் அ பிரபன்னஹ வி ஆர் நாட் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் ஆல் தோஸ் ஹூ ஆர் பார்ன் ஆன் திஸ் எர்த் வி ஆர் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் அ பர்சன் ஹூ ஆர் சரண்டர்ட் டு தி பிரிசெப்டர் எஸ்பெஷலி பிகாஸ் பிரிசெப்டர் இஸ் அவர் காட் ஆச்சாரிய தேவோ பவ இஸ் தி அட்வைஸ் கிவன் பை தைத்திரிய உபநிஷத் இன் யஜுர்வேதா அண்ட் வி சே ஆச்சாரியமான் வேத இஸ் அனதர் சென்டென்ஸ் we are all of us are termed as acharyavan meaning we have a preceptor to approach so prapannah so that means we have fallen at the divine feet therefore it is referred to here as tiruvadigalaye upaye upeyangalaga now how should we surrender what is the method to surrender what are the means to surrender the divine field themselves are the means to adopt the policy surrender. So upaya, upaya means meaning. In Tamil it has been misunderstood as some trick or so. If you want to have a shortcut method, it is upaya. It is not so. So upaya is not a cunning way of doing anything. So upaya means just means dharmic dharma marga righteous way of using the that means reaching the destination so tiruvadigalaye upaya then upeyangalaga so where should we reach what is our goal what is our aim what is our target again divine feet of the lord so there is Both are not different. Upaya and upaya are not different. The means to reach God and the destination are not different, or they are one and the same, and they are the divine thing. So upayangalaga patri ujjivikkavum. So we have to take recourse to the divine feet as our path, road, and destination, and then. We have to redeem ourselves. Ujjivikka vendum. Now, this is a paradox when all of us who know Tamil should be given explanation in English. I'm sorry if I make some mistakes. I'm also learning with you. Please remember. So, if I make some mistakes, please correct me perhaps at the end remember the mistake and correct me at the end paratattvam avadu now we are talking about the jnanam the wisdom that we get as the difference between the highest and the lower objects so paratattvam avadu what is the highest principle so svavyatirikta வகைகள் எல்லாவற்றுக்கும் நவ் தேர் ஆர் ஒன்லி டூ கேட்டகரி நம்பர் ஒன் த ஹையஸ்ட் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் நம்பர் செகண்ட் கேட்டகரி இஸ் ஆல் கிரியேஷன் தட் மீன்ஸ் ஸ்வ வெத்திரிக்த மீனிங் டிஃபரண்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஹிஸ் ஓன் வி ஆர் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் லார்ட் லார்ட் ஸ்ரீமன் நாராயணா ஆஸ் அ மேன் ஆஸ் அ மாஸ்குலைன் ஜெண்டர் பர்சன் But it is not so. We cannot understand whether he belongs to a particular gender. So because we call him Tvameva Mata, you are our mother. Then you are my father. You are my relative. You are my friend. You are my wealth. You are my education, knowledge. You are everything to me. So when we take a lot of relationship, we don't have... much stress the importance of the gender but still for practical purposes we always for clarity we say that he is parama purusha okay so one more thing Mr. K. Raman adds to beautifully प्रशांत बिल्कुल ठीक सर. इट इज ऑल्सो वेलकम. At the same time, I would also request those people who want to add, substantiate the statement here by their oral presentation at the end of the session, what they wanted to convey. So, Dharakanumai, Dharaka, it has been explained in the footnote, but still Dharaka meaning nourisher, sustainer, one who maintains, then Niyanta, one who controls, one who has a sway over, then Sheshi is the master. So Sheshi is the master. So Sheshi Mana. Now before going to the next page, we will take up all these explanations. So A, the footnote A, Chiranda Acharyana Anugrahata. So you have a best teacher with you and therefore his blessing comes true. Then B, so para avara uyandatum taandu vyamana tattvagale patti arivu. C, sadhana mahom phalana ho. So that is what I said, upaya and upaya. So sadhanam, instrument. So what is the instrument that we use for reaching the divine feet of the Lord? The very divine feet. Phalan, what is the use of our prapatti, total surrender? That also is Lord's divine feet. So our goal is Lord's divine feet. Our fruit is Lord's divine feet. Our result is Lord's divine. D. Tannaitavara matra. That's what I said. Swavitirikta. Different from his own. E. Sarubatal daripanam. Now, how does he maintain us? How does he support us? How does he keep us in sustenance? Sarupatta. Sarupam meaning, that has to be explained in detail. Sarupam means he has got vatsalyam, affection, karunyam, pity, compassion. And therefore, he is compassion incarnate. And take an example of Rama. He is Vigrahavan Dharma. He is righteousness incarnate as a king. So, Sarupattal Daripan. Because of his innate quality, original nature, he is ready to support us. Then, F, Niyanta, Sankalpattal Niyamipavan. It is enough that he decides. Sankalpa is decision. And he decides first in his mind and then he controls. So G, Payane Permava. So the G is given as I said master, he is a master. But who is the beneficiary? If at all he protects us, if at all he saves us from trouble, if at all he takes care of us, what is the purpose of the Lord? He becomes happy. So he becomes glad, he becomes elated because of protecting the Jivatmas and all other creations also. So you have the word by word meaning which we saw earlier. If anyone would like to read or repeat or any doubt or clarification, one can ask now. Otherwise we will go to the next page. Anybody can add something if you want. So, please do not worry about the recording if at all done by Keshavdas Swami. That also will be reflected in the your ideas also will be reflected in the YouTube upload. Don't worry about it. It is human to err. We make mistakes here and there, and they will be recognized and they will be excused also by each other. So Shriyapati, who is that Paramatma? We call him Sri Appati. That is a special what we saw in the previous paragraph as Swarupattal Dharippam. Swarupattal Dharippavan Lita, Dharaka Noi. So, how is he Dharaka? How is he a nourisher? How does he take pity on us? All this because of Mahalakshmi. Because he is the husband of Mahalakshmi, he has more compassion. So, Shriyapati, the husband of Mahalakshmi. Shri is Mahalakshmi. So, Sataha, Sataha meaning on his own, naturally, intrinsically, Sataha. Sarvajnanai, so he knows everything, omniscient. Sarva Shaktiyai, he is omnipotent. Parama Karinakanai, that's why now I said, Karunya Puraha, Parama Karinakanai. He has been very generous. He has been graceful, highest in gracefulness. Then Sarva Sharanyana, he is fit to be surrendered to by all. Sarva Sharanyana. Parama Udharanai. Just now I told you, his generosity knows no bound. Parama Udharana. His broad-mindedness, his outlook is the broadest, highest. Moksha Pradhanai. Now, Moksha Pradham, as you know, there are so many things about Moksha. Moksha is not traveling from earth to Vaikuntham. Or by what you call, there is a path shown by Shastras called Archiradi Marga and so on. So we are not worried about it. So Moksha is emancipation, liberation, beatitude, freedom from birth and death. We will stop the cycle of birth and death. So that is called Moksha. So only God who can accord Moksham is Sriman Narayana. So we say Moksham Ichche Janardana. So Moksha Pradhanai. Then Mukta Prapyanai. A released soul will have to reach the Lord. A released soul is called Mukta. That means they have reached Vaikuntham. And he is also fit to be, fit to reach. Rather, Lord is fit to reach. We give a certificate. Lord is fit to reach by the Mukta, the released soul. The released soul will have no birth and death. So, Paramyuhadi, Pancha Prakara, Shubha Ashraya, Divya Mangala, Vigraha Vishishtana Yirukum. Now, what is Paramatma? Divine Paramatma. So, this is Paramatma. So, his figure is tangible, Vigraha Vishishtana. You can touch him. Because he is in Archa form, the temple, you can touch him. So, Vigraha Vishishtana. So, he has a form. This is where other philosophies differ. Namely, they say he is arupam. He has no form. He is a formless one, shapeless one, colorless one, and permanent one. The other philosophies call them. We also accept them. But we have what we call ananta kalyana guna. We have got auspicious qualities in infinity. Therefore, so we call him Vigraha Vishishta. Vishishtaha meaning specially, extraordinarily endowed with a figure. With a figure in the sense, one can see it, one can feel it. So all the indriyas of pancha indriyas or dasha indriyas of our body, including mind, the 11th organ, sense organ, can have the feel of the figure. So Vigraha. So how is the Vigraha? Mangala Vigraha. Auspicious Vigraha. No bad qualities attached to that. So nothing inauspicious is accruing to that figure, and it is always divine. Now again, these words, some of the words are not very easily understandable by all of us, because we have not experienced. So we might have experienced in our mind, but we cannot say it out. We might not have experienced it, but we will explain. We will explain it in detail. Kandavar vindadillai, vindavar kandadillai. Those who know how to give all details did not see, have not seen God. Now again, Divya Mangala is again almost synonymous with Shubha Ashray. Whatever is attached to the Lord is always auspicious. Shubham. Shubham is equal to Mangala. So Shubha Ashraya, he has a substratum, he has a base which is auspicious. Meaning, nothing untoward happens, nothing bad happens. So no danger, no risk. Then again, Pancha Prakara. So we will take up this Pancha Prakara by looking at the footnote in D. And then in C, we have Paravyuhadi. There are five forms. And those forms are Paravyuha, Vibhava, Antaryami and Archa. So Para is the highest. And he is called Vasudeva, Paravasudeva. There are names attached to that. And Vasudeva is getting repeated in almost all the forms. Namely, Vyuha, they have got four forms corresponding to the portfolios allotted to divisions of himself. Sankarsana, Aniruddha, Pradyumna and Vasudeva. We will be able to explain it later. So, Adi is etc. So, five forms. So, this Pancha Prakara may refer to these five forms or maybe some other. We will see it later. I am also reading with you. Ivanai Olindavai Avaratattva. So when we define Paramatma like this, that means he has five forms and he has got auspiciousness as his base, and he is divine and auspicious in his form and figure, and he has been extraordinarily like this. So whatever is other than this Paramatma, that's called Avaratattva. Avara meaning lower. So it is Namana Dattva. So idu chetanam endrum achetanam endrum irandu vagaiyaga irum. This Avaratattva has been divided into two categories again. So sentient chetanam and achetanam, insentient. Then you have $1. So we will read it later. So chetanamana Avaratattva. So what is this sentient object? Avaratattvam. Oh, Avaratattvam is the lower one. Parichinnamana ahamartham. Parichinnam means limited. G is limited. Parichinnamana aham artham. So we are talking about ourselves as aham, I. The word I refers to jivatma, the individual soul. And of course, we are always mistaken with our body, our physical frame is mistaken to be Jivatma, because in spite of the knowledge that we have that the individual soul is different from the body, we cannot divorce the two aspects, because they are intermingled. Without a body, a soul will not exist. If it is not this body, another body is there. What you call sukshma sharir. So whereas we have got sthula sharir. Again, just like Lord Vigraha Vishishta. So we have got a Vigraha. Two hands, two legs, two eyes, two ears, and so on. So we have ahamartham. So the meaning of the word I is a limited one in the case of sentient object which is lower than the Lord. And you have some quality, capacity. Those capacities are Jnatratva, Kartratva and Bhoktratva. This is Parayatanga. So, though we feel we are active, we are doing some activities, we know something, we enjoy something. So all this, our knowledge, wisdom, our action, our activity and our enjoyment are all under control. Parayattam. What is that para? Again, Lord Sriman Narayan. Para is Paramapurusha, other is called Bhagavan, other is called Paramatma. So he has a control over all our knowledge, action and enjoyment. So our freedom is limited. Freedom of thinking, freedom of action, and freedom of enjoyment is limited. So, Bandha, Mukta, Nitya Rupatale. So, among the sentient, this category called sentient under the bigger category called Avaratattvam has been divided further into three. Number one, Baddha. Baddha means tied up. We are our fettered souls, chained soul. The second category is Mukta, released soul. And Nitya is permanently released soul. So, Rupam, form, by Rupam, Rupatale, Trividham. So, three types. Now, what are these three? Already explained that in the next line, few lines. Baddharavar, samsarikkumavargal. So we are in, as a human being, we are in a particular fashion of life. So we have family, we have children, we have friends, relatives, enemies. So we are all bound by many conditions. So muktaravar, samsaram kalithavargal. That means they have stopped their cycle of birth and death. They are released souls. They are in Vaikuntha. And there is another concept in another philosophy that even as a living human being, we can be a released soul. That kind of concept has been not accepted by Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya at any time. So Nitya Ravar, ஒரு காலத்திலும் சம்சாரம் இல்லாத நித்திய சூரியன். So there are only three people called Nitya, including of course people wise Nitya, as we understand. Even the Panchayudam, namely five weapons of the Lord, are called Nitya, permanent residence of heaven, if you say. Heaven is Vaikuntha. So all the five weapons, whatever is associated with God closely, he is always a Nitya. That you can take it up. That's it. But generally, our understanding is Adishesha, the serpent bed, Garuda, the kite, the vehicle, and the chief of army staff, the security, namely Vishvaksena, are called Nitya, permanent resident of the Vaikuntha. So, ஒரு காலத்திலும் சம்சாரம் இல்லாத நித்திய சூரிகள். You have not heard about these three coming to the earth as a human being. But one may say, Garuda Amsha was Periyalvar. Periyalvar was Garuda Amsha. But it was not a full incarnation like Matsya Kurma Varaha up to Kalki by Lord Sriman Narayana. And of course, you find that in Ramavatara, Bharata was the Amsha of Shankham, Panchajanyam. sorry, Shatrughna was the Amsha of Chakram, Sudarshan, the disc or discus or the wheel. And Lakshmana was the Amsha of Adishesha. In Krishna Avatara, you find Balarama is the Amsha of Adishesha. We call Ramanujacharya as the Amsha of Adishesha. and so on. So we have Patanjali Maharishi, who wrote Yoga Shastra, also as the Amsha of Advaita. So here, so many Amshas are there, but the full, complete incarnation is done by, performed by only Lord. So this, that means these Nityas are not affected at all.
Mr. K. Raman wanted to know about, he wanted you to explain again about Paramodara.
Udara means generous. The word, if you write in English spelling, it will be different. Therefore, it should be U-D-A-A-R-E, Udara. It's not Udara. We would like you to write, give the, what you call, diacritical mark, spelling. Of course, common, common parlance is Udara. The Lord is extraordinarily blessing us with his abundant deeds of kindness. Okay. So, even Mukti is rejected in Ramananda. Right? So, Udara. Okay. So, any other comments?
Eye-opening fashion. Could enjoy and then could get a very not aware of the tradition of they are able to get a good deep understanding that nothing other than Charanagati will make us united with the great supreme being. That right. Great message is delivered by our Professor Tirunarayanji in this session. He has used very simple terms in order to explain the great Paramatattvam. So my profound namaskaram to his holy feet. I too have a doubt. I wish to know the difference between Kaivalyam and Moksham. Is the same term or any other different subtle difference there? I request you, sir, you can throw light on this aspect. Please.
Your question was asked previously in many sessions by Keshavdas Swami, the organizer.
I have attended only this time. First time I'm attending.
And
sorry, sir. Sorry for creating inconvenience, if at all.
So, Keshavdas Swami will help me to substantiate the answer to the question. Before that, I would like to just go through the chat that we have. Because I have... So, Ati Saralya Shailya Prabhashyati Sati Kutova Samshaya. So, the word Prabhashyati used to be used in Atmanepadi. So, Prapannaha Sharanarthi Bhavataha Bhagavantam.
Bhaktaha, not Bhavataha. Bhaktaha. It is Bhaktaha, Swami.
Oh, Bhaktaha. Okay, Bhaktaha. Upayaha Dharmika Margaha Paddhati. Okay. Anything else? I would like to enjoy your comment also.
Thank you. Mahan dhanyavadaha. Bhavatam aashirvada mamopari sada bhavatu.
Mama vayaha tu kevalam saptati avaraha. Saptati una.
Saptagiri samanao bhavan.
So...
Saptanam Girinam Yad Mahatmyam Bhavati Tavat Mahatmyam Asti Bhavatam Vayasaha.
Prathamataha Mama Mahan Pramodaha Karanam Kashchana Vruddaha Jnana Vruddaha Atra Agatya Samskrite Bhashanam Paraspara Varta Vinyogaha Vinyogamati Karoti Iti Mahan Pramoda.
Kalyana Raman Aham Katam Bhavata Sahana Militva Sambhashanam Nakaromi. Yetat Mama Saubhagyam. Mama Mahan Anandaha Mama Magat Saubhagyam. Yet Bhavatam Prabhasanam Shrotum.
I wanted to introduce Dr. K. Kalyan, Dr. Kalyan Raman. V. Kalyan Raman. I wanted to trace some history of Dr. V. Kalyan Raman. His father, Venkateshwara, he was in Salem. He organized all state, Tamil Nadu State Sanskrit Conference with his sponsorship and support. he made all his three children study Sanskrit. I think two daughters and Dr. V. Kalyan.
And my brother also.
Daughter,
one more brother.
First daughter was a professor of Sanskrit in Queen Mary's College, Chennai, Autonomous College. And second daughter is a Sanskrit teacher in Kadalur. And third, Dr. V. Kalyan Raman is the principal of the Kendriya Vidyalaya school in Perambanur today. So please
thank you, sir, for your great introduction. I'm very glad to inform you that we have been conducting the service of propagating Sanskrit through online also nowadays. And then we are associated with all the samitis also. And then my sister and everybody in my family, we do participate in all the programs wherever we get an opportunity to attend or hear any wherever Sanskrit is spoken, wherever Sanskrit is taken as a core subject. Even yesterday also I could participate in a national seminar conducted by the Lokabhasha Prachara Samiti. And then this before coming to this session, and I could got an opportunity to conduct Sanskrit class where like this, no, many were attending it. It's a great service that I get an opportunity given by the Almighty to learn every day. I keep myself energetic by learning. And then it's a great association with Tirunarayana sir is a great thing for me. It's not like it is more than a Guru Shishya. He's one, you know, in my family. How we interact with my own brother and sister, the same way I used to interact with him. And we feel, you know, one in the family. So that is how I'm able to improve myself, update myself, all these things. A great opportunity that today I got the introduction of Mr. Keshav Das, who is the real inspiration for us. And sir, taking you as a motivation, I feel that I need to do more than that, what you have been doing. Thank you very much, sir.
Vinita Narayanan has a doubt. She wants me to explain Paramodara. Very simple. We are all Udaras, if you call ourselves. We are all generous, broad-minded, helpful to others, and for broad-minded to myself, broad-minded to my family, my minded to others, in a selfless nature. Paramodara is only Bhagavan. Paramodara is the highest generosity lies with only the Lord. We cannot overtake Him. That is what we call Paramodara. The kindness which He shows, we cannot show to others. The amount of kindness that He shows excels, surpasses any quantity of any individual. That's called Paramodara.
So somebody's asking if I'm going to say something about the difference between moksha and kaivalyam.
Right.
So the thing is, we were talking before that if we understand kaivalyam as a type of moksha, but normally when Sri Vaishnavas, when we talk about moksha, we talk about kainkarya, we talk about actual service to the Lord, which means that we are engaged in His service and He is accepting our service. So two of us are engaged in a relationship. But kaivalyam comes from the word kevalam, which means alone. So we are simply in kaivalyam, it seems that we are not having a full relationship, but we are simply enjoying brahmanubhava, the bliss of the individual soul, rather than the bliss of actually doing active service, active kainkarya to the Lord.
To explain to Dr. V. Kalyan Raman, kaivalyam is atma ramatvam, whereas moksham is paramapurusha ramatvam, paramapurusha aramatvam.
Dhanyavada.
Enjoying the Lord and enjoying one's own self.
Oh, dhanyavada.
Kaivalyam is not to be recognized as a separate heaven on the way to the final abode, namely Vaikuntha. But still, it is called Avantara Moksha. In concept, it is called Avantara Moksha. And that that moksha is to be attained first. Meaning, we must know what, who am I. I must know who am I. Then only I can understand the Paramatma. So what I must understand is, I am a slave. I cannot do anything. I am helpless. I have got karpanyam. I have got achinchanyam. I have got so many other handicaps. Whatever I decide, I cannot do. I cannot carry out. Everything depends on God. When you feel that the dependence, your complete dependence, that is called Kaivalya. So this is only to explain for a small introduction to Kaivalya. And there are many, 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 many words to rather address the issue.
So Swami, Mrs. Vijay Raghavan in Australia, she's asking about the concept of Jivan Mukti and Videha Mukti. In Sri Vaishnavism, we have this Videha Mukti concept that only after the body, which is made of karmas, is fallen, after the body has died, that the soul can go to full mukti. And it is not possible while we have this body made of sin to be fully jiva, to the Jivan Mukti is not a thing that can be possible. That a person can be very advanced, but he's not considered a Jivan Mukta as long as a material body is containing the soul. So I think that's a long discussion. That may be quite long.
The Jivan Mukta, the concept in other philosophy, has a limited scope. That means we are living in this world. At the same time, we have understood God. This is our concept. Meaning that we have no attachment to the world. We are always detached. But we must have no animosity, no hatred, no liking. Raga dvesha viyukta. According to Bhagavad Gita, neither you have attachment nor you have detachment. There is a neutral position. That is very difficult. So Ramana Maharishi is the only one considered as Jivan Mukta. And Ramana Maharishi was operated on his hand for the cancer. And the doctors asked whether they have to give anesthesia. He said, no. You can just operate. No knife, no clinical knife could harm him. He did not feel the pain. And therefore, because he considered that his body is not his. We say that our body is our possession. The possessiveness is also used to be given up in Jivan Mukti. It is very difficult. Therefore, Vedanta Deshika said that he prayed to the Lord in the daily Purvaradhana. Etat dehavasane maam tatpadam prapayasvayam. I don't want to commit suicide. If at all, I want to get moksha. As Keshavdas Swami got the word correctly, moksha is nothing but kaikarya. The service to the Lord, what you do in this world as well as next world. It is not moksha, it is not a travel. That's why he said, travel, visa to Vaikuntham, not a visa to Vaikuntham. Moksha meaning, you feel that you are dependent, completely dependent, and your mind is always concentrating on doing service to the Lord. Now, advising, it looks like an advice. Advising is very easy. Paropadeshe Panditiyam, Kalyana Ramahodaya. Practicing it very easy. Abhyasaha kashta.
I don't know how I have to take it. Whatever it is, I take it positively. No problem.
response from you.
Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.